wonderforest.com.
Okay, students, we are on the liquid solution chapter, and today's topic is one of the part of a colligative property. In our previous lecture, we have completed introduction to colligative property, and we have also completed one of the colligative property, that is relative lowering of vapor pressure. Okay, now we are going to study with the second colligative property. There are four colligative properties. They are all mentioned in my previous lecture. If not done by you, just I suggest you to go through it. If it is done by you, then it is well and good. Okay. So elevation in boiling point, it is a one of the colligative property. Okay. So colligative property means it depends upon the number of solute particle, but not on nature of solute particle. Okay. So as usually, I will try to explain you theoretically, mathematically, diagrammatically, and graphically. And at the end of this theory, then we will have some questions related to the this topic, which have already come in the previous entrance examination, and some questions will be anticipated questions. So if you go through this lecture thoroughly from the beginning to the end, then no problem will be there. Right from the basic level to advanced level, this topic will be fully covered. Okay, only thing I require and suggest you to come to this lecture, attend this video lecture with a notebook and pen, and with utmost sincerity to write down the in your own notes. Okay, and continue from the right from the beginning to the end of it. Don't skip it. It is not a picture to entertain you, so you have to maintain your interest till the last. Okay. So shall we start? Okay. So let us take about the elevation and boiling point. I am going to take three containers which are identical in size, identical in shape. Okay. So this is one of the container. This is one of the container. This is another container. And this is the third container. Okay, assume as if they are all ideal, even though they appear, if not appearing also, just take it as if they are ideal container. Okay, and initially all of them are filled with the same amount of the volatile solvent. What is this volatile solvent? Okay, so they initially they all have the volatile solvent, equal amount of volatile solvent. What amount of equal amount of volatile solvent was initially available? Okay, and then after that, in place of the solvent, some solute is added. Let us take container A, container B, and container C. Okay, and in the container B, some solute particles are added. Okay. And in container C, more number of solute particles are added. When comparison to this, more number of solute particles are added. Okay. So this simple will show you the solvent. Simple circle. Means solvent, and filled circle will show you the solute. Okay. And solvent is what? Volatile. Solvent is volatile, solute is non-volatile. Now I think concept is understood. Now I am closing down everything. Okay, so after certain time you will find some vaporization. Okay, so because of that vaporization you will find some vapors. Okay, so when you compare the vapors, number of molecules in the gaseous state, they will be large enough. Okay, and here when you compare them, they will be further less, and there will be further less. Okay, why it is? Just in the previous lecture only I explained, again once again I am explaining, but for better clarity I suggest you to go through that if you got any problem in understanding them. Okay, here all the solvent particle available on a surface, evaporation is a surface process. and all the particles available on the surface can evaporate. Therefore, rate of evaporation will be fast and number of gaseous molecules will be high. Here, some places are occupied by solute. So all particles are not evaporatable. Number of particles which can evaporate are reduced. Therefore, number of molecule in gases are further reduced. Okay. Here, more number of solute particles, so less number of solvent, less evaporation, less will be the pressure. Okay. Now, if I take it as a suppose 7 particles are there. Now, here it is 0.7 atm. Let us take the vapor pressure here over is 0.7 atm and vapor pressure over is 0.5 atm and vapor pressure is over is 0.2 atm. Okay, so this is all just because of the number of particles. Okay, as the number of particles are more, pressure is more. Number of particle less, pressure is less. Number of particle further less, pressure is further less. Okay, it is internally related to relative lowering of vapor pressure. That's why in my previous lecture I clearly told you these three colligative properties are interrelated. Okay, what are the three colligative properties interrelated? First one is relative lowering of vapor pressure, second elevation in boiling point, third freezing point, depression freezing point. Okay, so same similar diagram I have drawn there also, but some part explanation part is different. Okay, now so boiling point, before understanding this you should know the definition of boiling point. Boiling point is a temperature. Okay, so temperature of liquid is a temperature of liquid. Okay, that everybody know. You may thinking that sir what he is saying. Okay, so but from the basics it is my habit to explain right from the basic without missing a word. Okay, so boiling point is a temperature of a liquid. Okay, at which, this is the main condition, at which this I will write it here. Okay, the temperature of a liquid at which vapor pressure is equal to atmospheric pressure. Okay, vapor pressure is equal to what? It should be atmospheric pressure. Okay, so when you keep on heating a liquid, its vapor pressure will increase, and when it reaches to at certain point, at certain temperature, it reaches to 1 atm. That 1 atm temperature is called as a boiling point. Okay, the temperature of a liquid at which vapor pressure becomes equal to atmospheric pressure, that is called as a boiling point. Okay, that concept is very very important. When I ask the students in the class what is boiling point, then they will say in the other way. What is the other definition every student knows? Boiling point is the temperature at which liquid converts into gas. That is also correct definition, but for this situation it is not appropriate. That's why I mentioned. So boiling point definition, as a scientific student you should say the temperature at which vapor pressure of liquid equal to atmospheric pressure. Okay, now I wanted to boil them all the three. Okay, which requires more heat, which require more temperature? Here to reach 1 atm only 0.3 atm is to be increased. Okay, to reach here how much is required? 0.5 atm is required. To reach here 0.8 atm is required. Okay, so more pressure is to be raised, more pressure is to be raised here, least pressure is to be raised here. Okay, so that means when you increase, when I increase the number of solute particle, the amount of heat or the temperature required for reaching to the 1 atm is also increasing. Is it understood? So this boiling point is TB solvent. Okay, this boiling point is TB solution. Okay, solution 1. Now I will take it as a TB solution 2. Okay, so from this diagram you can imagine, this I am erasing, I will write over here. Okay, so solvent and solute, now everybody understood I hope. Okay, then with this you can also come to know here less heat is required or not. So TB, as the number of solute particle increasing, then boiling point also increases. So elevation in boiling point is a colligative property because it depends on the number of solute particles. Okay, so now I will write one thing. TB solvent, TB, otherwise you can write here itself. So in between these three, what is the sign required? Okay, what it is? Solvent solution 1, solution 2. Is it clearly visible? Okay, so TB solvent, TB solution 1, TB solution 2. Now you can tell me what type of sign you can write, like this or like this. Here more work is to be done. The pressure is to be raised to 0.8 atm. Pressure is to be raised to 0.5 atm. Pressure is to be raised by only 0.3 atm. Obviously the temperature required is less here and temperature required is more here. Okay, so this diagram I purely drawn it only to show number of solute increases, that property increases. Hence we are proving that this property is a colligative property, otherwise not required. This diagram is not required, only to show that number of particle increases, that property, colligative property also will increase or decrease. Okay, so here it is increase, sometimes it may be decrease also, but depends on number of particles only, to prove that this diagram I have drawn. Okay, now for, and once it is proved, then I am eliminating this. Okay, so this TB solvent, TB solution, A and B, both are understood or not? So this is also not required. Okay, now for, I am explaining here this, when you add a solute, boiling point is increasing. That increase in boiling point is only called as a elevation in boiling point. Okay, so now you can you can understand and find out the definition of elevation in boiling point. What is the definition? It is the increase in boiling point. It is the increase in boiling point when a non-volatile solute added to volatile solvent. When a non-volatile solute added to volatile solvent, such increase is called as elevation in boiling point. Okay, so it was lesser boiling point and its boiling point increased. When it happened? When a non-volatile solute added to it. Okay, such increase is called as a elevation in boiling point. I think everybody understood or not? Okay, now let us start with the next part. What is the next part? How much it is increased? Okay, then what we will write? TB, TB solution minus TB solvent. I am clearly pronouncing, sometimes it should not be misunderstood. Okay, because of the my good handwriting, sometimes it may not be understood. What it is? TB solvent. Okay, so this is denoted with delta TB. This is denoted with what? Delta TB. Okay, what is delta TB? Elevation in boiling point. In future, whenever I say delta TB, that means you should understand it is solution minus solvent and it is elevation in boiling point. Okay, now it depends on number of solute particles or not. So that delta TB is directly proportional to molality. Okay, now some question came, why molality is taken in elevation in boiling point, even though molarity also contains number of moles. Okay, why? Because molarity is equal to number of moles upon volume. So here volume changes with temperature. We are dealing with temperatures. So it not only depends on number of moles, it also depends on volume. So to avoid this contradiction by the volume, it has been replaced with the molality. Molality does not involve any volume terms. Okay, so delta TB is directly proportional to molality. Therefore, delta TB is equal to KB into molality. This is the definition and mathematical form. Okay, so if you want, you can extend here also. Okay, delta TB is what? TB solution minus TB solvent. Okay, so don't rely on the screenshot. Okay, right. Try to write on your name with on your own notes. Okay, this is TB solution minus TB solvent is equal to delta TB. Okay, it is also clearly written over here. Now, mathematical form definition part, diagrammatic explanation is over. What is the which form is left over now? Very good. Graphical form is left over. Okay. Okay, some more clarity is required on this formula. Delta TB is equal to KB into molality. Okay. So delta TB already I told you. It is the boiling point of solution minus solvent. Okay, mainly we should concentrate on KB. KB is called as a ebullioscopic constant. And it is also called as molal elevation constant. What it is called as? Molal elevation constant. Okay, and its mathematical formula. This is generally required for higher end questions. Okay, higher end numericals, higher end entrance examination only. But for the basic purpose, state level entrance examinations, for this formula is not required. Only for advanced level examinations, this formula is required. R is a universal gas constant, boiling point of solvent, molar mass of solvent, and 1000 into enthalpy of vaporization. Okay. One more thing I wanted to tell you. This is only for solvent. Okay. KB is defined for what? Solvent, not for the solution. So if you aqua solution is mentioned, that means everywhere you can use the same KB value. For all aqua solution, KB value is fixed because it contains water as a solvent. Okay. So KB depends on the nature of solvent. Okay. Now, why it is ebullioscopy? Because this method can be used for finding out the molar mass of unknown solute. So that method is called as ebullioscopy. The method of determining molecular mass of unknown solute is called as, based upon the elevation in boiling point, is called as a ebullioscopy. Why? Because see here, molar mass is equal to, sorry, molality is equal to mass upon molar mass of solute into mass of solvent. Okay. Here this is mass of solute and this is mass of solvent. Okay. Mass of solvent. So by using this can be experimentally determined. Okay. And how much dissolved we will come to know, this can be determined. Is it understood? So based upon this formula, whatever the way we are identifying the molecular mass, that procedure is called as ebullioscopy. That's why it is called as a ebullioscopic constant. Okay. Mathematical form, experimentally, diagrammatically, it is explained to you. Only graphical form is left over. Okay, now this is the graphical form. Here on the y-axis, what is there? Vapor pressure. On x-axis, what is the temperature? Okay. So I will draw the two lines like this. In this one graph is for vapor. When you increase the temperature, vapor pressure will increase. Okay. Now let us take, this is P, this is Q. Now you have to identify P is graph for what? PQ is graph for what? P is graph for solute or solvent. Q is graph for solute or solvent. You should select. You can identify. Try. Okay, good. So this graph is for solvent. This graph is for the same solvent after mixing the solution. Okay. How you can identify? Because you are perfect in my previous lecture. If you attend the previous lecture, that smartness will be shown immediately. Because I told you in relative lowering of vapor pressure of solvent is always higher than vapor pressure of solution. Okay, here more vapor pressure. Now let us take here, this is 1 atm. Okay, so this pressure, let us take 1 atm. Understood? So the temperature corresponding to 1 atm is called as what? Boiling point. So this is the temperature corresponding to solvent. Okay, So TB, this is called as what? Solvent. But in the same condition, when I dissolved solute into it, boiling point is how much? Solution. Okay. So boiling point increased or not? So this gap itself is called as a delta TB. Is it understood, students? How delta TB is came? Delta TB is elevation in boiling point. Elevation in boiling point. So delta TB solvent minus TB solution. Okay. Like this, you can understand now. I don't think any problem is there now. Okay. So this is graphical representation of the elevation in boiling point. Now theory part, I think you are perfect. Definition, diagrammatic explanation, mathematical explanation, and graphical explanation all are over from my side. Okay, are you ready for the next segment? Let's see.